NASA today announced a new launch date for its big moon rocket, the Artemis 1 SLS. It was rolled back into the vehicle assembly building ahead of Hurricane Ian for shelter. And West 2's Scott Heidler reports this afternoon from the Space Coast on this next step.
After two mechanical scrubs and then Hurricane Ian, NASA's lunar test mission of its Artemis program is now targeting November 14th for liftoff, just after midnight. The SLS rocket stack rolled back into the VAB just days before Ian slammed the Space Coast.
This is a positive step forward, I think, for NASA, because before they rolled back, they were really pretty concerned about some of the life-limited items on the rocket.
The rocket had been stacked for over a year and had been on Pad 39B for about 7 weeks.
So that gave engineers time to look through the many parts of the SLS, including critical systems like self-destruct, and check on the fuel in the Orion spacecraft.
NASA saying that the 322-foot rocket will roll back out no earlier than November 4th. They're confident that the issues that kept it on the ground are fixed and that minimal work is needed to get it flight ready. But its hydrogen fuel, the reason for its last scrub, might continue to test launch teams.
I don't have any confidence in NASA or anybody's ability to deal with hydrogen at such a scale with a brand new vehicle like this. I think that it's quite likely they will have additional challenges.
If the SLS performs and the countdown goes as planned on November 14th, the mission will last 25 days, shorter than the mission if it launched earlier in the month. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.